This is Patrick Creef, and you're watching Stingray Pause Play.
I am Zach Monson. Welcome back to a very special edition of Stingray Pause Play here with Canada's own Creef, Patrick Creef. What can I call you, my friend?
Patrick or Creef.
Creef. Who calls you Creef?
Anybody in my family.
Really?
Yeah.
Like grandma calls you Creef.
Well, no, that's how they would pronounce their own names.
Oh, okay. So that's the actual way to say it. And I just sounded like a fool.
No, thanks, you said it. That's Patrick. The stage name version of it is Creef, because that's how it reads in English.
What is the first memory that you have of picking up a guitar?
At my grandmother's place, my uncle had guitars laying around, and my first memory is not being big enough to actually pick one up, so just opening the lid and playing like that.
Yeah. You once told me that you enjoy slightly random and odd questions.
It's possible I would say something like
that. Yeah, it sounds like something you'd say.
Yeah.
So what's your ideal sandwich, Patrick?
That's a tough one.
I know.
But I do like a bagel and lox.
It's a good one.
Yeah.
You should come here Wednesdays. Yeah. Wednesday mornings, bagel and lox all day.
That's a good sandwich.
You'll come. We'll hang out.
Yeah.
Eat some lox. Have a schmaltzy chat. If you could change one thing about your outfit today, what would you change?
I feel like it's a little Canadian tuxedo-ish.
Yeah. You're killing the jean thing. It works.
And but that was intentional.
Okay.
If I would change something about it, I would get my boots fixed up a little bit.
Okay. Shined?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
I kind of like the matte black. It works.
Yeah. They're 12 years old. I've had them for 12 years.
You're a musician. You can't afford to buy stuff.
No, I can't.
No.
No. Well, when I can, I don't spend it on clothing or reasonable items.
It's the newest pedal.
Yeah. Something like that.
Yeah. If you could only listen to three songs for the rest of your life, what would they be?
Happiness is a Warm Gun.
Yeah.
Jealous Guy.
Okay.
By John Lennon.
Okay.
And since I'm clearly in a horrible situation,
on the Beatles train, it seems
I would say Hello Walls by Willie Nelson.
Oh, nice one.
Yeah.
That was a good choice.
Yeah, because I'm figuring I'm isolated somewhere, right?
Yeah, of course you are.
Yeah.
What is your favorite musical moment that's happened in your life so far?
As a performer? Or moment?
I'll leave it up to you.
I went to see Ray Charles in the 90s.
Wow.
And that was probably my best moment.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
What was your favorite part of that show?
I just liked... I mean, it wasn't my favorite part of the show itself, but something about how he comes on stage, he plays 50 minutes, and then he leaves. There's no encore, there's none of the... no crowd interaction, no bullshit, you know, just like...
Just plays...
Class act
does
show.
Does his songs...
And then he
gets
the fuck out.
Yeah.
I love it.
How long did the crowd scream encore before they realized it just wasn't going to happen?
I was with my dad, who'd seen him before, and he's like, let's go. He's not coming back on.
Okay.
And I was like, no, we got to make
Stick
some
it
noise.
Out. Stick it
so
out.
I was one of the idiots that was hoping he'd come back out, but he didn't. And the more I stuck around, the more I was like, this is amazing. He's not coming back.
Yeah. We asked the last artist to ask you a question. And that question is...
Hey, I'm Matt Halbuski, and I just want to know what color your shower curtain is, because that's not creepy at all.
We're really getting into some deep stuff here, Patrick.
It's gray.
It's gray.
Yeah.
That is the most boring answer you could have given.
Well, I have like this...
You had an opportunity to make up something so good, and you chose gray.
I have this like Art Deco super like canary yellow bathroom.
Okay.
Like all the tiles are super yellow.
Okay.
It's like you need sunglasses going there.
Okay.
So I got gray shower curtain, gray everything, and it kind of dulls out
just
the yellow.
Just to tone it down a bit.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. So it's a smart move.
Yeah.
Boring choice, but smart move.
Yeah.
The new album is Automatic. Forso album, double album, 20 songs. You said that you've made a lot of miserable and negative music in the past, and that this album is the closest thing to positive that you can really do. Tell me a bit about that statement.
It's the closest thing to positive that I've done. I think I can do better
than
that.
So in the future, we can expect some more happy stuff, but for now...
Possibly.
Yeah, okay.
It depends. So what was the tail end of that question again?
Tell me a bit about what you mean by saying that.
Right. I just didn't, I didn't feel like crying in my own beer, you know, with this music. I felt like there was a lot of bad things going on in my life, and I didn't feel that, you know, I just didn't feel like playing the victim anymore. I was about taking accountability, and I was noticing not only in my own behavior, but around people, you know, people around me just always going, oh, I have bad luck, I have bad luck, and starting going, actually, you don't have bad luck, you're just a fucking asshole.
Yeah.
And I had to say that to myself too, you know, yeah. Like just kind of, not that I'm an asshole or anything, but yeah, no, it's not that I felt that I was a bad person. It's just that I was saying, hey, there's a lot of bad things around me that are here by strictly by invitation. Mm-hmm. And that's true for almost anything in anybody's life. You don't like your job, that's your fault.
Yeah.
You know? So I started doing what I called it, like an epic cleanup. Getting rid of people, getting rid of, you know, leaving bands I didn't want to be in anymore, like just clean up. And at the same time, I was writing the lyrics for this album, and I they were all starting in this kind of dark place naturally. And I felt, you know, by the time I get to the end of this song, I'd like there to have been some sort of hope lyrically.
Yeah.
So that's where it's... There was a bit of an effort to make sure it wasn't just like slit your wrist.
Not all gray shower curtains all the time.
Not all gray. Yeah. You know, there's a couple bit of yellow ones yeah, in there. Okay. Pink, blue,
it's
whatever.
It's beautiful, really. Both discs, I say discs, he's even out, but really, really beautiful. And they fit together nicely, even though they're so different. It's a nice grouping of songs. With so many songs to choose from, it's hard to talk about just one. But tell me a bit about the song Magdalena. What kind of story are you telling here?
That's about the fool's errand some people are on, trying to please people that are unpleasable.
Yeah.
If that's even a word.
It's a word.
Yeah. So I think that's kind of what that song's about. It's kind of addressing this character that is never satisfied and always blaming you for it. And then wondering, what would it be like? Is it possible that there is somebody out there you would praise and you would treat well? And who is that person that you would do that to? And yeah. I wonder, you know? And then you start making something up in your head, and, you know, then you realize there is nobody like that.
Yeah.
So that person becomes part of the list of the shit you cut out of your life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Again with the cleanup.
Yeah.
Always cleaning up.
Cleaning up.
Yeah. I think it's important to do.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. I like cleaning.
There's a... nobody likes cleaning, Patrick. There's a little bit of Cohen kind of in this song. There's a little bit of Leonard Cohen in the song. And, you know, we lost Leonard Cohen not too long ago. We lost Prince. We lost Bowie. We lost Sharon Jones, Fife Dog. The list goes on for all the people we've lost in 2016. Why do you think that people react so strongly when they lose a musical hero?
I think it's very easy to get really connected to people on an emotional level that are saying things that are so, that resonate so much with your life. And there's a sense of nostalgia too. Like a lot of these people, you grow up listening to them. They're like part of your childhood. And, it's upsetting on that level that I think you feel connected to them, kindred, whatever. And then there's probably a little party that was hoping you'd meet them one day.
Yeah.
And you go, well, there's that, you know?
That's gone.
Yeah. I mean, I know I take it that way.
Yeah.
Because when George Harrison died, I just, not even 6 months earlier, I just crossed paths with him, almost was able to meet him.
Yeah.
And I thought, oh, you know, I'll meet him.
Yeah.
I just came that close.
Yeah.
And then he died. And I was like, damn it.
Well, there's always Ringo.
I'd like to meet Ringo. I met Paul.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
How was that?
It was... If it weren't Paul, I would say it was an embarrassing experience, but I'm sure he's so used to the type of reaction I gave him that it wasn't embarrassing.
Which was?
Well, in my head, I'd mapped out this whole, don't get excited, don't say you're his biggest fan, don't say anything stupid, just say thank you. That was my plan. I'm going to reach out my hand and say thank you.
Patrick, what actually happened?
I just froze. I didn't say anything. And he was walking, and he was like, hey. And I was like, And yeah. my hand was here.
Yeah.
But it was like it went from here to there. I was like,
Paul.
Really, really,
Paul, it's awful.
Really, and he looked at me and he was like, okay. You know, like, yeah. like, oh, it's one of those, you know, yeah. like, no problem.
Yeah. Good to meet you too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I thought I came to terms with that. I came to terms with it as a good meeting.
Yeah, it was not.
I thought this is, I thought, you know what? That's just perfect. Yeah. You shouldn't speak to him.
No. What could you possibly say to him that somebody else hasn't already said to him 1,000 times?
Yeah, maybe punch him. No, I'm just.
Punch him. He would remember you. You'd be a memorable visit for him.
He
for
actually
sure.
had a seriously imposing bodyguard. And that was maybe part of why I was so uncomfortable. I was worried that if I, you know, my hand came out too quickly, yeah. my fingers would get yeah. broken or something.
Wait, he needs the bodyguard because there's people like you out there who are like, I'll just punch him.
Yeah, I'll just, never
I'm not
going to
say hello. I'll just
for
punch,
the record, I would
I'll
never,
just punch him in the
I
face.
Would never strike yeah. anybody, yeah, I'll just ever. Punch
him. Thank you for chatting, my friend. You going to play some music for us?
We'll do our best.
You'll do
it. Yeah.
I hope so. That's why you're here, Patrick.
Yeah.
That's why you're here. You can hear Creef's music on Stingray Music's Canadian Indie Channel, Rock Alternative Channel, and all over Stingray Music Vibes. We'll see you next time, guys.